Jesus' name. Everlasting Father, we give you praise, we worship you. Thank you because you are the God that corrects your children whenever they go wrong. I pray as many that will hear this, we take your correction and do the best for you in Jesus' name. Amen. Jesus' warning to Deeper Life Bible Church. As I prayed early this morning, 12:25 a.m., for Deeper Life brethren, telling the Lord to save them, to have mercy, that how can these fine, spiritual, equipped brethren perish because they stumble at holiness revival movement worldwide? Holy Mom. The Lord immediately interrupted and said, how we do not perish. Just as Israel stumbled at the rock laid in Zion, that is how these people are stumbling at me. Don't you know I am the one in Horemon? Just as Israel stumbled at me when I came, that is how these are stumbling at me, Horemon. Now read 1 Peter chapter 2. Immediately I stopped praying and went to read from 1 Peter chapter 2 verse 1. I found what he was telling me in 1 Peter chapter 2, 6 to 8. Wherefore also it is contained in the scripture, behold, I lay in Zion a chief cornerstone, elect, precious, and he that believeth on him shall not be confounded. Unto you therefore which believe, he is precious, but unto them which be disobedient, the stone which the builders disallow, the same is made the head of the corner, and a stone of stumbling, and a rock of offense, even to them which stumble at the word, being disobedient, whereunto also they were appointed. The Lord continue, just as I choose Israel to be the oracle of God, and custodian of my law, and they were my people whom I was preparing so I could come through them for the salvation of the world. But they missed it. They thought the covenant was an end in itself. They did not know that it was a means to an end. So when I came, they did not accept me, did not want to use the scripture to know me. They could not understand the whole aim of my coming to the world. In the same vein, Deeper Life was chosen to bring the message of holiness to the whole world. I was with them, but they missed it when they became a church. And they thought they were an end in themselves, and pride came in. Just as when Israel refused me and asked for a king, I did not throw them away because I had no other to fulfill my plan on earth. So I continued with them until I came through them. My purpose must be fulfilled. So as they rejected me, it did not stop my message to the world, because I choose people from among them, the apostles, to reach out to the whole world with the message of salvation. In the same vein, when Deeper Life failed me by becoming a church and pride eventually entered, I did not cast them away because I had no one like-minded who will prepare people through whom I could fulfill my plan of reaching the whole world. I, with my message of holiness, when the appointed time was come, I chose Paul Rica and some brethren from among them, just like I choose the apostles from the Israelites, to fulfill my plan of reaching out to the whole world with the holiness messages. Israel's mission was a message of salvation to the whole world, which they rejected to be part of by rejecting me. While Deeper Life's own mission was a message of holiness to the whole world, which they missed and still rejected by refusing to be part of Horemon for the same purpose. Now, what happened to Israel is exactly what is going to happen to deeper life. At the end of the world, all Israel shall be saved. In the same way, before the end of time, deeper life will come together with Horemo. But what will happen to the Israelites who will not live until the end of the world? They will perish. The same will be the case with deeper lifers. All these ones who are rebelling now against Horemo will perish in unbelief if they die before the amalgamation of the two bodies, Horemo and deeper life. Jane, do you see now, just like the Israelites who come to believe me before the end of the world are getting saved, so also are deeper lifers who come to believe in Horemo. In the interim, we'll be saved. I have been talking to you to see the resemblance of deeper life with Israel in various ways. But today has made it quite open to you. There is no more ambiguity. So help those who can rescue from deeper life, open it to them to come out of the ganging up against Horemo. They will not succeed in what they are doing. Horemo will keep on progressing, and those fighting against it will perish, except they repent and come and join hands with Horemo. Jen, do you understand now? Yes, Lord. Thank you, Lord. 2 a.m. Second message. After I had written the above revelation down, I fell down and praised God for giving me the revelation. Then I began to pray to God for deeper life again, weeping as I remember all the big spiritual equipped men in deeper life, pleading that God should bring the amalgamation between Horemo and Deeper Life Church quickly so that these men will not perish. By visiting the GS of Deeper Life himself so that his members will believe in Horemo. As I was crying between 2 a.m. to 2:05 a.m., I was sharply rebuked, "Get up and stop." The Lord began to speak again, that he did not want what I was doing. He said, "Are you not a deeper life? Is Puerto Rico not a deeper life? What of your in-law and your sisters? What of all the other deeper lifers in Horemo? How did you people come out and believe in Horemo? Did not hear that many are called, but only few are chosen? Don't you know only few people will go to heaven? What other visitation do you want me to pay for deeper life before they believe in revelation? Did I not take one of their members to heaven and hear from their midst so that they could believe and take this message to the whole world to be saved? What a wonderful effect it would have been for deeper life to have been the one doing what holiness revival movement worldwide, Horemo, is doing now. But they miss it again. They prefer to be in their own enclave of pride and let the whole world perish in their worldliness and sin. They want all humans to come to their church. What Horemo is doing is the way, the going from place to place with the message of holiness. When they have gone around the whole world, has heard the true message, then the end will come. What Horemo is doing is not convert the whole world, but as they go, those who hear and believe shall add to the church, such as should be saved. Deeper life is among the whole world. So in the same way, irrespective of their status or spiritually, anyone among them who hear and believe shall be saved. But those who harden their hearts or are fighting against Horemo will perish like any other person in the world. Even in Horemo, it is not everybody that will be saved, except they hear and believe and practice. So stop being emotional about it. You are to go among deeper lifers. explaining these things to them so they will not perish. I will not consider that they have been long in the church, or that they have been big in the church, or that they suffer or discipline themselves, or are training themselves and have been serving me. What of Muslims or those who fast for 40 days or more, saying they are serving me? Will I look to this if it is done in sin? If these so-called big people in Deeper Life Church have truly been following and serving me and man, will not they not know the move of the Spirit, to which direction he is moving in this present time? How did you know and came to believe in this revelation? You were more religious and ardent than many of them. Be convinced with this final scripture about anybody's final salvation, no matter who or she is. Ezekiel 18:23-24. Have I any pleasure at that the wicked should die, said the Lord, and not that he should return to his ways and live? But when the righteous turn away from righteousness, committed iniquity, and doeth according to all the abomination that the wicked man doeth, shall he live? All his righteousness that he had done shall not be mentioned. In his trespass that he had trespassed, and his sin that he had sinned, in them shall he die. Why I have taken time to say all this to you is for you and others who read this message to be convinced about the wickedness which Deeper Life has done, is doing against Horemo and my message. Jane, be comforted that I know all those who are mine, and they shall not perish. Good morning. 2:56 a.m. Epilogue. My beloved Deeper Life brethren, I want to assure you that this message is from the Lord. I also want to assure you that it was the Lord that brought me out to serve in Holiness Revival Movement Worldwide, Horemo. I am not backsliding. Rather, I am growing more and in my relationship and communion with the Lord. Those of you who relate with me can testify to this. Brethren, believe this message from the Lord and stop resisting Horemos. Believe also that the true revelation. Remember, Joel 2:28-29. Oh, brethren, the Lord is waiting for you to join hands with Horemo in the end time message of holiness and righteousness to the whole world. Allow the church of God to flow together as in Acts of Apostles. There were no denominations, but Church of Christ, one Lord, one faith, one baptism, one God and Father. Ephesians 4:5. This is the mission of Horemo in the nutshell for this end time. Brethren, don't incur the wrath of God anymore, and you will enjoy abundance of peace. I love you all. Shalom. Sister Jane Malu, Deeper Life Bible Church, Refugees, Plateau State, Nigeria. Heavenly Father, we thank you for this message. I pray that the Deeper Life that have heard this message will do your will, in Jesus' name. Amen.